Good morning, YouTubers. Thanks for joining me today. This is probably my third or fourth installment in a series of videos about this MRG frog. The left is the MRG BF1001R1. This is the MRG frog. Man, I'm gonna call this watch the frog as we compare it with this Oceanus. This Oceanus is the Oceanus OCW P2000. Couple things about this, these two. So the frog is purportedly the first ISO rated MRG dive watch. Although all of them are rated to 200 meters, they're not ISO rated. The Oceanus is also called the Cachalot, and it is the first and only 200 meter ISO rated Oceanus diver. They both use what I would say is essentially the same module. They have essentially the same feature set with one key difference. They're both very big. They both wear quite comfortably. The Oceanus you can wear under a shirt cuff, the MRG you cannot. They are both made of dual layer hardened coated titanium, all titanium. They're both solar powered, blah, 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 blah. They both have great lume on the hands and dial. Excellent lume. The Oceanus has a rotating bezel, which is clutch, but only the pip on the bezel glows. The MRG does not. They both have a dive timer. They both have stopwatches. They both have buttons that can be depressed underwater without flooding the watch. They both have world time, so on and so forth. So what are the big differences? The MRG has an alarm, has a beeper, an alarm from the timer. When you set the timer, it'll beep. The Oceanus doesn't have a timer. It has only a dive timer. So it has a dive timer, but no regular timer. They both have a stopwatch. They both have a tide indicator. I think the tide indicator is, for me, absolutely useless, but it's there. I think I would rather both of these watches have like a pulse rate, you know, monitor than a high tide and low tide indicator. I suppose like if I lived in, I don't know, like, somewhere where I didn't have easy access to a smartphone or Wi-Fi or cellular signal everywhere, I might like having the tide indicator, because like if I lived on the water or something, that might be a nice feature to have. You know, like if I lived in coastal Indonesia or somewhere. The case back of the Oceanus has 8 screws. Super cool. It's like a cool case back. Solid. The case back of the MRG has this stupid glass medallion. So it has a display back that didn't display anything. It's like a glass case back for no reason but to be blue. They say it lets the signal reception out for the Wi-Fi or the Bluetooth and all that. Man, I don't think that's true. I don't really know why they have a glass case back. Maybe because they thought that by putting it on it would be more premium. Seems like a feature without substance. the Oceanus uses traditional spring bars. So like you could put it on a regular strap. I think I have a video where I'm wearing this on a NATO strap, which is nice. The Frog has this proprietary lug, but it has a quick release feature. This little button that you press and it allows you to pull this strap attaching pin out. I really like the feature. I'm just sort of frustrated with Casio that at least yet they don't have rubber straps that you can just swap out. Like the flexibility of having a quick release strap is so that you can swap straps. So why is it that they don't sell swappable straps or bracelets for the model? You just get what you get when you buy it. So it seems kind of a missed opportunity, but maybe that's part of their long-term plan. Doubt they have that, but you know, who knows? One can hope. Both have a screw-down crown. Both are ISO rated. The Oceanus has 3 buttons, just like the MRG, but the MRG Frog has 4 buttons. Let me just put these kind of together so you can just sort of see some of the size of these. The MRG is very much the big mamma jamma, sort of the, you know, the big guy on cell block. The Oceanus is much more svelte, much more, you know, versatile, much more chic. Lots of polish on the MRG, on the Oceanus. Almost no polish on the Frog. They're both a lot of fun to look at, honestly. They have lots of dimensionality to the cases. Lots of polished features on the Oceanus that contrast with the brushing. Lots of contrast brushing on the Frog. They're both a lot of fun to just look at in the light. Not all watches have that, but they do. The Frog has a lot more X factor. The Oceanus definitely has X factor, though. So, what's the moral of the story? I don't know if there is a moral of this story. These are both really cool watches. I've had the Oceanus for a couple or a few years now. The Frog is a new acquisition. I wear them. I actually wear these watches somewhat regularly. I'd say they're both weekend watches. The Frog is more of a watch I'd wear, you know, exercising or on the weekends when I don't have to wear sleeves. The Oceanus I could wear anytime. I love that you just pick them up. Once they get a little bit of light to the dial, they flip to the right time and date and you can go. You don't have to set them. That's always an awesome feature, especially if you swap out watches with any regularity. They're cool watches. They're very well built. The Frog is really expensive right now. I would say, like, you know, if you have a big collection and the Frog seems to fit, go for it. I think it's worth the money. I didn't pay retail, let's put it that way. But, you know, I think the finishing and the build quality is worth the price point at retail, but you just got to want to wear it enough to get your money's worth out of it, if that makes sense. It's like, is it worth it? Yeah. But if it's going to be worn in a big collection, will you get your value out of it? I don't know. I think that's a tough sell. People have to ask themselves that. So far, I'm getting my wear out of it, that's for sure. The Oceanus was expensive when I bought it, but now they almost give them away on Chrono 24. I'm not sure if they're still manufactured. I presume they are, but like, this has got to be one of the best value dive watches you can buy if you like solar powered quartz and, you know, great lume and great feature set. Like, these are durable watches that are very comfortable and very well built, far better than what you get from, say, you know, a Pro Specs at this price point, in my honest opinion. I think they're made by the same facility that makes the Grand Seikos, which means they probably made better than the Pro Specs. And then if you can, and I have the Pro Specs and I'll compare them to Pro Specs, but truly great watches. Okay, that's my quick side-by-side comparison between the Oceanus OCW P2000 and the Casio MRG BF1000 Frog. Thank you for joining me. Please like and subscribe. Know that I post new content on Fridays. Be well.